In this video, I will show you how to stream music and how to create a playlist on YouTube Music. Streaming music means that you can listen to songs straight off the internet without having to download any files onto your computer. Now, there's many streaming platforms online, and YouTube Music is one of them. It's a really great platform to collect the songs that are important to you or your loved one and to create a playlist. Now, in this video, I will show you how to set up a YouTube Music account and how to set up a playlist. Now, let's get started and set you up with a YouTube Music account. All you need for that is a computer with internet connection and a mobile phone. Let's get started. This is my desktop. Let's open an internet browser. You might be using Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, or Firefox. Any internet browser will do. The address for YouTube Music is music.youtube.com. Click on Sign In at the top right corner. To use YouTube Music, you need a Google account. Now, if you've used Google services before, your Google account details might show up here, and all you have to do is put in your account password and log in. If you have not used Google services before and you do not have a Google account, you will see this screen and it will be empty. But don't worry, creating a Google account is easy. All you need to do is click on Create Account for myself, then put in your name. Next, we need to put in an email address. You can either use your current email address if you have one already, or create a new one. Now, I would say the easiest way to log on to YouTube Music is to create a new email address. So I would recommend to just follow the steps here to create a new email address for YouTube Music, even if you have an email address already. So let's create an email address. For that, you click on Create a new Gmail address instead. Type in a name for your email address. Then create a password. Make sure to remember the email address and password you're putting in here, as you will need it in the future to log on to YouTube Music. Now click on Next. Now sometimes when you create an account with YouTube Music, Google will want to verify that it's you creating the account and not somebody else. For this, you will need to enter your mobile phone number. Google will then send you a 6-digit verification code as a text message. Now click on Next. Enter that 6-digit verification code right here and click on Verify. Google now would like to know your birth date and your gender. So let's fill in our birth date here and our gender. This information will help Google keep our account secure. Click on Next. On this page, Google offers to add your phone number to your account. But for using YouTube Music, I would just recommend to skip this step. So click on Skip here. On this page, Google is showing you the terms and conditions for creating a Google account for YouTube Music. Have a read through these and scroll to the bottom. At the bottom, you'll find two boxes which you need to tick. With these boxes, you're basically agreeing to the terms and services of creating a Google account. Click on Create Account. A little pop-up box will appear. In this pop-up box, Google is asking you if it can use personalization on your account. So if it can show you recommendations or personalized ads based on your previous use. Click on Confirm. You have now successfully created an account with YouTube Music and can start creating a playlist. To do so, click on the magnifying glass up here, which will open a search bar. Type in one of your favorite tunes. Now press the Enter key on your keyboard, and that will show you all the songs that YouTube Music has found for you. There might be different versions, but most of the time, the top result is what you're looking for. To listen to the song, click on the image next to the title. You'll now have to watch an advertisement. Right after, your song will start playing. In some advertisements, this little Skip Ad button will appear after a while. You can click on it and the app will automatically get skipped. You can pause and restart the song by clicking on the play and pause button in the lower left-hand corner here. Now let's create a playlist. For that, all you have to do is click on the three little dots here, and a box with options will pop up. Click on Add to Playlist, then on Create a New Playlist. A box will pop up with your name. Click on Create Channel. Then give your playlist a name. Click on Save. Your song has now been saved in a playlist. Let's add another song. How about Hey Jude by the Beatles? So you search for the song in the search bar. Click on the image to play it. Then click on the three little dots to open the options box and click on Add to Playlist. You can now directly add your song to the playlist you've created in the previous step. You can access your playlist anytime at the top of the page. On my screen, the top of the page is right now hidden by the search bar, so I need to click on the little X to close it. Now we can see our navigation panel at the top of the page. To access your playlist, click on Library. You'll see your recently played songs at the top, and when you scroll down, the playlist you have created will be shown here. If you click on the image, the playlist will open. If you click on the little play symbol on the image, your playlist will start playing automatically. You can skip songs by using the forward or backward button on the lower left-hand corner. One click on the forward button and the next song will start playing. You can add as many songs to your playlist as you want. And the beautiful thing is, the playlist will be safe for you. So when you open YouTube Music next time, your playlist will still be there and is ready to be played. As you'll notice, YouTube Music will show you quite a lot of advertisements when you listen to your playlist. That can be a problem and can make it harder to enjoy the personalized playlist you've created. If you would like to listen to your playlist without advertisements, you need to sign up to YouTube Premium, which carries a monthly subscription fee. It's very easy to sign up. Just click on the little circle up here in the top right-hand corner. In the menu that pops up, click on Get Music Premium. On this page, you can see how much your subscription will cost you every month. Often YouTube Music offers a free trial month, so you might not get charged for your first month. Click on Try It For Free. To purchase your monthly subscription, you now need to put in your credit card details and click on Buy. Now don't forget that this is a monthly payment, so it'll be taken out of your bank account until you ask it to stop. But don't worry, cancelling your account is easy. Just keep in mind that this is not a one-off payment of £9.99, but a monthly subscription. You can cancel your subscription at any time on YouTube Music. Similar to when you started your YouTube Premium monthly subscription, click on the circle in the top right corner. You will then see an option called Paid Memberships, and on that option, you can cancel your membership. You now have a YouTube Premium account, which means you will no longer see advertisements. It also means you can download your playlist and listen to it when you do not have internet access. For example, on your smartphone when you're out and about. YouTube Music is a great way to create and listen to personal playlists. When you are done listening to your playlist, you can exit YouTube Music by just closing your browser window by clicking on the little X on the top right corner here. And you're back to your desktop screen. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope you got inspired to create your playlist on YouTube Music.